Greetings. I am Herbert Erpaderp, and today I'm going to build the Universal Carrier from the Flames of War British Armoured Battlegroup box. For an overview of the entire box set, there's a link in the description and a card in the upper right-hand corner of the video now. You can of course get these Universal Carriers without having to buy the box set, but it does look as though this is the only individual box of plastic carriers that you can get, which is for mid-war. But I don't see why you couldn't just use them for other periods too, unless the Universal Carrier is unsuited to early war. I don't know. The point is, you can get these carriers without having to buy the other tanks you might not need. They come in a box of 9, so it's too bad if you only want one, but most people probably need or want more than just one. Because I don't actually have that platoon box, I can't show you exactly what's in it, but I've got the important things, like the unit card, which has some useful information about the vehicle. There would be decals, but they do seem to be different to the ones in the battlegroup box. I would assume, as usual, that there are no instructions inside the box, but there is an exploded diagram on the back of the box, and you can find some assembly instructions on the Flames of War site, linked in the description. Or you can continue watching this video. I would recommend that option. I do have the most important item from that box, the sprue. This is unsurprisingly quite small, being that the Universal Carrier is a tiny little vehicle. I am unsurprised to see that this is very neat and crisply molded with very nice detailing. I couldn't find any errors, and there are next to no mold lines. They are there and will need to be cleaned up, but it doesn't look like it would take much work to do that. This is the quality I expect from Battlefront's plastics. There's a handful of options for this model, which I like. You can fit this with a flamethrower, a boy's anti-tank rifle, or Bren guns. There is also this set of crew and passenger figures. I am almost certainly not going to be using these. They don't quite look as nice as the vehicle itself does. There are 3 of each: driver, front gunner, and I assume passenger. They seem to be made of the flexible plastic that Battlefront uses now. This is the first time I've encountered it. It's not quite as flexible as I was expecting. Oh well, let's get to building. I start with the tracks. This is just a simple matter of gluing the entire hull side with tracks onto the central hull part. It locks into place very easily. It's designed in such a way that if you're putting it on wrong, it will look very, very obvious. Unsurprisingly, it's exactly the same on the left side of the carrier. As usual, I apply pressure to be sure that no gaps appear. Next, the rear, which needs a little something, so I add this part. The fit is a little bit tight, but it does go in. I put the part on to test fit at first, and it seemed easier to just tilt the part back and put glue in there rather than taking it all the way off, applying glue and then reattaching it. I put a bit of glue on the join line at the bottom for a bit of extra glueiness, and it's on. Looks pretty decent. I then attach these side guard things. This is keyed to suit the hole the part goes over, which makes it very easy to install. I found I needed to apply a little bit of pressure to get the part to click into the hole, but it did click in. Nothing too tricky here. And that's the basic assembly done already. That was super quick and easy. Now, some decisions need to be made. First, do you want to have a crew? You might have trouble installing the gunner if you put him in after the front gun. I've chosen not to install a crew. Partly because I don't want to paint them, but mostly because the figures don't really look as good as the vehicle. The detailing is a little bit soft, especially in the faces. I suppose at this scale a really crisp face isn't all that necessary, but I do think the vehicle will look better without them, at least in my opinion. The crew figures are somewhat flexible. I'm assuming, and pretty sure, that this is the new flexible plastic that Battlefront are making figures from, but I did expect it to be a little less stiff. Oh well, moving on. The second decision we need to make is, what gun do you want in the front mounting point? If you want a flamethrower, there's a couple of other bits you need to add. However, I've chosen the Bren gun, because why not? This can simply be glued into the gap in the front here. It's not quite keyed to fit. You could easily put this part on a bit misaligned, but the parts are angled, so it should sit in place neatly with a minimum of gaps. Fits pretty neatly and looks good. I am sure the gunner figure could be forced into place here behind the gun, but I would expect it to be quite easy to damage the gun. If you do want a crew in your Universal Carrier, I think the easiest way to paint things separately would be to leave the forward gun off as well as the crew and paint all of the parts separately. That way, you wouldn't be forcing the gunner in past the gun, which would likely result in scratching some paint off. The final part to add, if you want, is this pintle-mounted Bren gun. I glued it onto this whole thing here, like so. It doesn't slot into the hole, rather it sits on top. Maybe I used the wrong mounting point, I'm not sure, but it looks okay to me. This part is optional. You can see on the artwork for the carrier patrol box that none of them have a Bren gun on a pole, and for some reason the instructions don't even mention it. Looks fine to me though, so I leave it at that. The Flames of War plastic universal carrier, or I guess in this case it might be called a Bren carrier, whichever, is now complete, and I think it looks quite good. There's a lot of good detail on it, especially considering its size. Owing to the small number of parts, it was very quick and very easy to put together. I don't have the older resin carrier to compare this model with, or any others, but I feel like it would probably compare favourably, at least in my opinion. Having built this one, I am pretty certain that I'll buy the box of 9 carriers and enjoy building them. I would imagine that 9 is a sufficient number of carriers to have. I think this is a very good-looking little model, and it should be fairly useful for a British or Commonwealth army, or even a Soviet force. It could even be used by other nations like Germany, and there's a bunch of modifications you could potentially do to this vehicle if you are so inclined. It seems like a pretty versatile little vehicle. What do you think? Let me know in the comments section below or on Discord. And also do all the other things like subscribing here on YouTube, following me on social media, and watching me live stream on Twitch. And if you really like the things I do, please consider helping to support the channel over at Patreon. That would be rad. Links to all of those things are in the description below. As always, I shall return soon. So until then, be excellent to each other and thanks for watching. Farewell.